Hello kids, I am Mona Bhatt and today I am going to teach you how summers and winters occur, correct? How they take place. Now see the first picture. Can you see the globe, the earth? Yes, in the exactly at the between. What is it? Can you see the equator? Yeah, the equator is a line which divides the earth into two parts, equal parts. Now, when you go towards the north from the equator, you will find the topic of Cancer, and then you will find the topic of downside. At the south, you will find the topic of Capricorn. Yeah, this you already know. Now let me see, tell you how things happen, how you get, how do you feel hot, when you feel cold, when is it summer, when is it winter. Clear? Now see this picture, kids. Now what happens? On 21st June of every year, the sun's rays fall directly vertically on the areas of topic of Cancer. Which area it falls? Direct rays of the sun, topic of Cancer. Yeah, so because the rays are direct, it is very very hot over there. Yes, and because direct sun rays are there for a longer time, so it is called as the longest day. Clear? So 21st of June is also called the hottest and longest day in the northern hemisphere. Clear? This day is also known as summer solstice. What is it known as? Summer solstice. Yes. Now, and the opposite side you will find in the southern hemisphere, there is no sun rays. Very slanting sun rays you'll find. So there it will be shortest day and very cold over there. Clear, kids? So from this summer solstice, what did you understand? When the sun's rays are falling directly on topic of Cancer, that part receives direct sun rays, so it is very hot and it is the summer season over there. And 21st June is also known as the hottest and the longest day in the northern hemisphere. Clear? And that time southern hemisphere, the sun's rays hardly reach. So there it will be very cold. It will be very short day over there. And it will be very cold over there. So that day it is in northern hemisphere, it will be summer. And in southern hemisphere, there will be winter. Very good, kids. Now what happens after 21st June? Slowly, as the sun is going on rotating, what happens? Rotating and revolving, then other parts of the earth will face the sun's rays. So after 21st June, you will find from Tropic of Cancer, the sun's rays are reaching on the equator. Where they are reaching? Equator. Yes. All of you, can you see? Sun's rays are now falling on the equator. Now what happens? As sun's rays are falling on the equator, the sun's rays will reach equally on the northern and southern hemisphere. So after 21st June, when the sun rays start moving towards the equator, and on 21st March, when exactly the sun's rays are vertically on the equator, you will find day and nights become equal, because equal sunlight is falling on northern and southern hemisphere. So the day and night durations will be equal. Yes, and this is also known as March equinox. What is it called? March equinox, because on March 31st, the direct rays of the sun falls on the equator. Clear?